you know, you are doing this show and you do the Conan show all the time. Mm-hmm. Was Conan, first of all, was he like your talk show guy growing up?
Yeah, growing up.
I mean,
yeah.
How cool is that guy?
Oh, it was awesome. And it was meeting him and like kind of like, well, I wouldn't say we're friends, but I would say that he hates me. And and it's just so cool to have that, you know?
He doesn't actually know you're showing up that way?
No, we never talk about it.
Really?
No, we never talk about it. Every time he's just like, you know what? He's never happy about it.
Seriously?
Every time he sees me come out, it's the same expression, which is like, oh, God damn. And the other day, the last time we did it, he came back backstage while I was like extensively getting the makeup taken off. And he was like, you just don't want to talk, do you? And I was like, no, I'll talk to you. And he's like, oh, forget it, forget it. And I was like, oh, I blew it. But now I'm just going to go way harder.
But that's why you're here. I get to talk to you. You're talking with me. We're talking.
Oh, no, you bugged me for 2 years. That's what
that is true. That's how I get all my guests. You email someone enough.
But this is really like the most fun. This is so
this fun.
Yeah, this is great.
But do you prefer being in the hosting chair? Because
no,
Adam, no.
Mm-mm.
But you hosted the Late Late Show a couple years ago.
Yeah, it's so hard.
Was that hard?
Yeah, what you do is so.
It
this
looks
is so hard.
Man, you and Ben Schwartz. I have a clip from this, and we'll show it. But CBS trotted out some guest hosts while when Craig Ferguson left, they were hiring James Corden. They hadn't hired anybody yet, so they had a bunch of guest hosts come in: John Mayer, Regis Philbin,
mm-hmm. All the great comedy minds.
Adam Pally, who, you know, no ties to CBS.
No.
You don't even watch the network. Like, how did that even come together?
The producer of James Corden is this guy, Nick Bernstein, who used to be a producer on Saturday Night Live. And when I was really young, I auditioned for Saturday Night Live, and I did not come anywhere close to it. But he really liked me, and he liked a couple of my writer friends, and so he started to work with us a little bit, and we were, like, kind of, you know, we would go in and out of like, oh, maybe I'll get SNL, and then you're like, you're definitely not getting SNL, and then you'd move on to something else. And then he, after the whole Jay Leno thing happened, he kind of left SNL and went to Pete Holmes' show, and I've known Pete a long time, regretfully, and so he lets...
Would not respond to my emails, by the way, trying to get him tonight.
Don't worry about it. you're better off. You're a sweet guy. So anyway, so that's how it happened. So I did the Pete Holmes show a couple times, and then we've been friends for like, at that point it was like 12 years since my SNL audition, so he asked me to host it.
That's amazing to stay in touch that long. And let's just show a clip of this, because I thought it was one of the best episodes of the guest hosts.
You know, there's one of my favorite movies, Ben, is this movie called Bangkok Dangerous that Nicolas Cage is in.
It's a real film?
It's a real movie, and Nicolas Cage is in it, and there's like a 5-minute scene where he's out on a date with a deaf girl, and they're eating soup in Thailand, and he tries the soup, and for like 5 minutes he keeps going like this, like, it's hot. Soup is hot. The soup, it's hot. Steam. The soup is hot.
Yeah. Do it for the full
steam,
5 minutes.
It's like a hot steam. It's too hot to drink.
Commit for the full 5 minutes.
Too hot to drink. And then finally the deaf girl like reaches for the soup and he goes, no. It's too hot. If Regis were watching this right now, he would be like, get him off the air. What is he doing? I was killing.
Can you do me a favor? Can you do Regis doing that scene from Bangkok Nights?
Yeah,
if you don't mind, is that
it's
okay?
Bangkok Dangerous, by
Bangkok
the way.
Bangkok Dangerous, I'm
and
sorry.
Yes, of course. This is Regis doing the scene I just did from Bangkok Dangerous.
Thank you.
It's so hot! The soup! It's so hot!
What is this show? What is this show?
Looked like you were having fun.
Yeah, I was having a blast. Yeah, I was having a blast. But it's so hard.
Yeah.
It's so hard, yeah.
So you and Ben, as Ben Schwartz and Gil Ozeri.
Yes.
The third in the Troika, the Holy Trinity.
Yeah.
The three of you guys have been together for like 10, 12 years.
Yeah, which one's the MCA?
Yeah.
Definitely me.
But I asked about maintaining the relationship with your wife during the rise to fame, and then even maintaining friendships must be a little hard. I mean, jealousy entering into
it. Oh, always jealousy. Yes, of course. Yeah. Always competition. Always jealousy. That's what fuels the three of us. But also, like, love and support. And, you know, they're the two funniest dudes that I know, and I've known them forever. I guess a theme in my life, which I'm realizing now, is that if I meet you and I like you, we probably will be friends for a long time.
Yeah.
Which is maybe a good quality or a bad quality, because maybe some of those people are toxic in my life and I should be getting rid of them. Who knows, you know? But I'm not going to do anything about it because I'm afraid of conflict.
I'm glad we had this breakthrough.
Yeah, thank you very much. No,
I was
no,
I was looking at my ear.